Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. Today, I'm going to make a meatball in beer sauce, and I'm going to use our homemade Vienna lager that Julie and I make. I'm going to start out with a little bit of milk and some breadcrumbs, and I'm using really finely crushed breadcrumbs. You could use a couple of slices of white bread. You could use finely ground crackers. Doesn't really matter too much which of those you use. What you're looking for is a medium that's going to grab the moisture from the milk and then carry that through the cooking process so the meatballs don't get dry. And pretty much as soon as you mix this in, it fully absorbs the milk. So I'm just gonna set that aside. In this bowl, I have some ground meat. I've got a 1 pound chub of ground meat. To that, I'm going to add some thyme. I'm gonna add a little bit of salt. Some black pepper, and you don't need to over season the meat. There's going to be a lot of flavor in the sauce and it's all going to come together. Next in is some nutmeg, and I'm going to freshly grind a little bit of nutmeg in there, somewhere between half and a whole teaspoon, which actually is a lot of nutmeg now that I've just said you don't need to over season them. So I'm going to put that in. Next, I've got a couple of onions minced up really fine. Those go in. One egg. And the breadcrumbs. And there shouldn't be any liquid milk in there. It's all absorbed into the breadcrumbs. And get in there with your hands. Best way to mix it. Now you need to divide this up into meatballs. Pretty self-explanatory. And you can make them as big or as small as you like. I think maybe just a little bit smaller than a ping pong ball or somewhere around a ping pong ball and a golf ball. About that big. And it makes it a whole lot easier if you wet your hands, which I never do. But I understand that it makes it a whole lot easier if you wet your hands to get them formed without it sticking to your fingers. So I'm going to form these meatballs. And so I ended up with 17 meatballs, not all the same size, but pretty close to all the same size. And over here, I have a pan that's already preheated with some oil in the bottom. So what we want to do is just brown the outside of these meatballs. We don't need to cook them all the way through because we will be cooking them later in the sauce. And one of my problems is always I'm never gentle enough at this point, and I often get the meatballs broken up. So be very gentle with them, turn them very slowly, take care with them until they're nice and brown on the outside. Now there's still some oil in the bottom of this pan, the oil that I put in originally plus whatever came out of the meatballs. So I need to add a little bit of butter to bring it up a bit. I'm going to judge by what's in here. I'm looking for between 3 and 4 tablespoons of oil in the bottom to match the amount of flour that I'm putting in. And it doesn't have to be exact. You can just eyeball it. I'm going to add that much butter back in. I'm going to melt the butter down. While that butter is melting, I'm going to add in a sliced onion. And we want to fry that up to get it nice and not quite brown, but we want to get it translucent at least. You also want to put in some garlic. Now, I looked out in the garden today. I didn't want to pull any garlic out because I pulled a lot of garlic out already and it's not really ready yet, but the scapes are growing and this curly thing grows out of the garlic and it grows tall above all the leaves. And at the end is the flower, or where the little bulbils, depending on which kind of garlic you have. Some have a flower that gives you seed. I have some of those. And some give you a bulbule with tiny little garlics that you plant next year instead of planting a seed. So all I've done is chop those up. I'm going to put those in as well. What you have is garlic from the grocery store. Garlic from the grocery store is going to be just fine. So just going to give this a stir around. I'm going to scrape up the brown bits from cooking the meatballs, because that's going to add a lot of flavor to the sauce. And it's not going to take very long. As much as I want to get that translucent, I don't want to add too much color to them. So let's move right along. This is flour. I just want to put the flour in. and stir it in and coat it with the oil and cook it just a little bit. And that doesn't take long at all. Almost right away, I am ready for the beer. And like I said, I'm using our homemade Vienna lager. Use a beer that you like. I prefer a dark beer for this, and I prefer a dark beer that's not too hoppy. I like hoppy beers, I really do. But I find that in a dish like this, the more you reduce the sauce, the more bitter it becomes. And so a hoppy beer that you enjoy drinking all of a sudden becomes too bitter at the end to actually eat. So I'm gonna pour this in a little by little. I've got a whisk standing by just in case. There we go, it all goes in now. And you just wanna whisk that until the sauce is smooth. It's not gonna thicken up just yet. Really, what you wanna make sure is that there are no clumps of flour, which is a little bit hard to see over the foam from the beer. Now this is coming back up to temperature. We've scraped the bottom. It's gonna come to a simmer, and as it's coming to a simmer, I'm gonna put the meatballs back in. Now you don't want this to boil hard, because the meatballs will break up. So just a light, gentle simmer is what you're looking for. And of course, once you put all of the meatballs back in, if there's any juice on the plate, that goes in as well. Now I'm gonna put the lid on this and I'm gonna let it simmer gently for about a half an hour. At about the 10 and 20 minute mark, I'm gonna lift the lid and I'm going to turn the meatballs over, make sure that they're all in that sauce. I almost forgot the most important part. You need a little bit of sweetness to balance this out. Now, the first few times I had this and I made this, I used applesauce. Applesauce works really well. You need about a cup and a half of applesauce. Mix it in when you put in the onions and the beer. Maple syrup works incredible. And this is our homemade maple syrup that we tapped our maple trees this spring out in the garden. So I'm gonna put in about a quarter cup of maple syrup. Now, of course, you could use any sweetener that you like. Applesauce is probably the way to go if you don't have maple syrup. There we go. And I'll just take a spoon and gently stir that in and leave it to simmer. Hey, Jules.
Hey, Glen. Hey, friends.
So, meatballs in a beer sauce.
Okay. Why not?
Let's give this a go. There's one for you.
Why, thank you.
And one for me. And there's a lot of sauce here. Great for dipping bread.
Yeah, going rice.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you could put it on rice and noodles and all of those things.
Yeah.
As if you didn't want to just eat them with bread. So, a lot of the flavor depends on the beer you put in. Mmm. The meatball's really nice and tender, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. It's got a really sweet flavor. I wasn't expecting a sweet flavor.
Maple syrup.
I see you doing your dance of joy.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So, the beer really changes the flavor. Like I said earlier when I was putting the beer in, if it's too hoppy or too bitter to start with, it is definitely going to be really bitter.
You're going to want to pick something you like.
At the end. Yeah. If you don't like beer...
Add red wine.
Red wine or white wine. Yeah.
Well, but then, you know, if you really like hoppy beer, and some people do, you may really like hoppy meatballs. But
it's true.
I don't know. So feel free to try it. Let us know.
Don't let me sway you on that. But for my own palate, if it's too hoppy, it gets too bitter at the end. So many things you could do with these meatballs. Of course, you could make them really tiny, put them in a crock pot, serve them with toothpicks at a party. I know that at the family picnic, the meatballs go
really
first.
Quickly.
They're gone
it's
first.
It's true. It's a bit cutthroat. That in the current
fried
red
chicken?
Currant pie.
Oh, and the red currant pie at the end. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. So, really easy dish to pull off. You could do it in a crock pot. It would work fantastic. You could put it in the oven.
Options.
Options. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.